could you tell us what is your early memories about Dzogchen Rinpoche? How did you meet Dzogchen Rinpoche?
My early memory or Rinpoche's about Rinpoche?
About Rinpoche, your memories. When did you meet? How did you meet?
Oh, I met him in 1964, 65 in India. But I visit his Rinpoche's place in Pema Kue, we call Dezin Shuling, where he established two Dharma Center, what is called Nagpa Center and one Monk Center. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but when I visit there, when I was 6 years old with my mother.
6 years?
6 years old.
Okay.
I visit with my mother to see the Dzogchen Rinpoche's mother, Namgyel Drama. Then at that time, I could see only Rinpoche's centers, but Rinpoche already left to Tibet. I saw one of his younger son and Dzogchen Rinpoche's mother, Namgyel Drama, in Dezin Shuling.
And so when he became your root guru?
Yeah, this is as I got a teaching and the empowerment of three root in Orissa. He came there and he gave some of his, not only three root, but he gave us, there is an outline of Nyingma doctrine, what we call in Tibetan, Tenpe Namsha. And also Rinpoche gave his Dharma history. He written recently in Kalimpong. So from that, he become my root teacher, and especially in 1977 in Kathmandu, where all Dzogchen Rinpoche and Dzogchen Rinpoche himself, so all teaching was done. So I got everything. From since then, I'm practicing all his teachings, and he become my root teacher.
Okay, and did you receive Nagpa ordination from him?
Yeah, that's in through the Trungpa Nangmo. What's called empowerment in Nepal. I received Nagpa ordination from there.
And once you told us that he wanted you and some of your friends somehow to survive this Nagpa tradition, did you make some promises or something like that to him?
Yeah, this is because that was not in Nepal, but in Orissa. While we were staying there, we have some group of Ngapas, as you know, in Nepal, Lama Dawa is there, mm-hmm. and myself, now Lama Thachin Rinpoche is no more, and Lama Jansen is still in America, and Lama Trasidele. And we are five peoples, so we also because Dzogchen Rinpoche, our successor of the Mindoling, who established the Mindoling Center in Kalimantan. He have a sort of land. Then we were just thinking to just build up a wonderful Nagpa center. Even Mindoling they love because they have monk center. Other side you can have this land and you can develop a Nagpa center. So we were very anxious to do that. But after that we are just scattered here and there. So it doesn't work. But still wherever we stay, we ourselves is a sort of a Nagpa institution. Yeah. Everyone doing well. Lama Thachin done very well. Lama Jansen still is teaching in America. Lama Dawa is teaching in America. So I'm doing myself how I can do to preserve the Nagpa tradition. Mm-hmm. So this is that.
And how it was with Dzogchen Rinpoche? How his was style of teaching? What he was like? How do you remember him?
Yeah, as I told you, because Dzogchenpa is not only my teacher, because we have a sort of family relation from Pema Khoi. My great-great-grandfather married Dzogchenpa's father's sister, which is from Pune. So we have a family relations, and one of my uncle married also Dzogchenpa's eldest daughter, Chemo Deshen, who was called Trukhu Chunyit. He is also from my mother's side, sort of his uncle. So family relation is very close also, mm-hmm. not only after I got 65 mm-hmm. and then 1977 in Nepal, become relation with the Dharma. Actually, I belong to my family lineage is Pemalinga. And family and both in my bone lineage coming from the Pemalingpa, Pemalingpu. But because of my old family lineage and my old starting from the in Bhutan, it's called his name is written in Bhutanese history, it's called Changchub Gyantsen, but he became the one of the prime student of Jigme Lingpa. After that, he got Jigme Kundul. He is my great-great-grandfather, and he was a wonderful practitioner of Vajra Kilaya. Then we have got also the lineage of Jigme Lingpa through that. Then after that, I have like Jigme Kundul's son is called Lopun Delek Wangchu. Lopun Delek Wangchu's son was called Lama Donga. Lama Donga's son was called Lama Pema Rabten. And Lama Pema Rabten and my grandfather Lama Donga came to Pema Khoi. Then I am the son of Lama Pema Rabten. So we have the five lineage. All are just continuing with Ngakwa tradition over here. One after that, we get the lineage of Jigme Lingpa. We have lineage of Pema Lingpa. Then fortunately I met this great Tertun Dunjum Drundul Lingpa. So I have also this living tradition of I'm following Dunjum, which is lineage.
And how he was when he was teaching? How he was like a human being? How do you remember him?
Yeah, it's lots of memory about that. He's as we know, because Dzogchen Rinpoche, the early Dzogchen Rinpoche was very wrathful. He was it's like living Dorje Dolo. Also, Guru Rinpoche again is prophesied called his Dzogchen Dolo, Dorje Dolo. Because when Guru Rinpoche's time, he was called Hichong Lhotsawa. He was practicing Guru Rinpoche. He was also translator. Same time, he was a Ngakpa. And he was just under Guru Rinpoche, translating many Vajrayana texts, and also he was practicing with Guru Rinpoche. So he was sort of, he was practicing hard practice of Guru Rinpoche even those days. And then later on he accomplished the form of Dorje Dolo. And that lineage was coming, Dzogchen Rinpoche's old lineage, like Rintim Dulun Dorje, who was a wonderful teacher in Kato. Then after Dzogchen Lingpa, then Dzogchen Jigdre Shudo, no, Dzogchen Lingpa. Dzogchen Lingpa was born in Golok, but very, very wrathful. So difficult to have an audience with him. So like he was doing, like I can explain about how was looking the Dzogchen Lingpa. So very wrathful, always he have a sword with him, and just on the throne he sit, but sword is what that, and people he blessed with the sword people, and this side is he was like in the Golok like a king, so he's giving judgment, some two people fighting, so he says give a judgment, and this side he have some student who is just listening to his dharma, and just he just dictate them and they're writing dharmas, so wrathful. So after that, one upon a time, people ask, Dzogchen Lingpa asked, how is going my teachings. How you think? It's all things are just perfect. But one thing is people really dare not come and see you because you are so wrathful. One of his students just talked to Dungeon Rinpoche and says, oh, don't worry. I will really, and next my life will be very peaceful. So this Dungeon Jigdei Shidorji made it. So Dungeon Jigdei Shidorji so humble. And then unfortunately he have some trouble in Pemaku to stay because his father's side, this Kanamdeva, and the war with the central Tibet, and they have something dispute, and Kanamdeva was killed by them. And then after that, Dungeon Rinpoche was his two center, as I told you ahead. He holding this two center and all the sort of help that he getting to the Kanamdeva king. But they were stopped, and then also there sort of warning that he have to stop his center in Pemaku. Then he have to fled to Tibet, Lhasa. But it was for him, because like his bodhisattva was always, I think, good. If someone's harming, then bodhisattva is more, getting more powerful, more powerful, because as we call it, if we suppress bodhisattva, or what we call like the gold. Gold is if you put in a burning in a fire again and again, gold get more and more shining and more and more refined. Huh? So it was exactly happened to Dungeon Rinpoche. He went to Tibet and then he done teaching in Mindoling, and because of his belong to the incarnation of Rinzin Dundu Dorji, one of Dungeon Rinpoche's life. So he was because centered in the Kathok. So people like Dungeon Rinpoche should go to Kathok and stay there. They are longing, but at the same time Dungeon Rinpoche have a relation with Mindoling. He given teaching of the Rinzin Terzo there. So everyone loved to related with Mindoling. So Dungeon Rinpoche has not been to the Kathok, but he remained to stay in Central Tibet and Mindoling. Then after that, he have to visit because some jealous again in area in Lhasa, some jealous sort of the dispute problem was happening there. Then he fled to Bhutan. In Bhutan, the king and the ministers, they honor him too much. And then in Paro Taksang, what called the tiger dance, where he revealed this, he was doing meditation. While that, then he just discovered this Gongter of Pudurekpu. And of course, then he had to go back to Lhasa, because when he was 5 years old in Pemaku, one day he was just playing with the children, his age. Then sort of he was lost, and his friend didn't find him. And they are playing in a bush in around in Pemaku. Then other children went back. Then mother Namjin Rama was very worried about where he's been. It's getting late now. Then she just went to see there. And then Dungeon Rinpoche was, he just get a slip little bit in one place. And he was in Kapurkala Mountain. And he met Guru Rinpoche, and Guru Rinpoche, and Dungeon Rinpoche told Guru Rinpoche, please, I want to stay here. It's a good place, Kapurkala Mountain. Here I want to stay. But Guru Rinpoche and Ishitoja both give empowerment and instruction and say, you have to go to Pemaku. You have to need to do lots of work in Pemaku. So you have no chance. Later on you can come here. You are welcome, but now you have to go. So this, he, because then he just sort of wake up, then he have in small, this we have the cloth, small pocket, container was in his hand with the black pills. Then he wake up and just moving back to his home, mother come there and where you are lost. So then he didn't say anything, but hand over these pills to mother. And mother finds a black pill. So where you got this? And mother was very surprised. Then they went home. Like this. So this is the reason Guru Mbuchi authorized him to stay and go and back. You have to work. But obstacle was always there. So sometimes we have written a text says, Guru Mbuchi, you say, I have to do a lot of work here, but the people, say, human being, non-human being, both are very obstacle for me. What to do? Then anyhow, after that, he have to go to stop his center and have to go to Lhasa and teaching in Mindoling, and then went to the Bhutan. And after that, in Bhutan, he was honored. And Bhutan king told Dunyarbuchi, you stay here in our kingdom. It's your. We will, whatever you facility you want, we are ready to offer you. But Dunyarbuchi, same thing. He says, I have to go because I have to do some work. Guru Mbuchi told me to do some work. So I need to go back to Tibet. And then he went to Lhasa. Around that time, he discovered Khandututi in Lhasa. And then he had to go to Kongbo, and where he established, because he was making the copper color mountain, the copper color palace in, in Kongbo. And then a wonderful center for the Ngakpas. Actually, it's not Ngakpa, but Rinpoche being a Ngakpa, many monks and lamas from the Kham, because of the from Gatok, from the Central Tibet, from the Derge and Golok, everything was just Kham, him around him, and then they stay there, and they getting teaching from them, and same time he was doing this copper color, a pilot there, then get one after another, gather many, many peoples. All were just a wonderful, some were from the Nyingthig lineage there, already Lama, and some followers, some of them. But he is in Tibet at that time, it's believed Dunyo Rinpoche is leaving Guru Rinpoche. So they give up everything and they come and just stay with him. And after all this in Kongbo, it becomes this, we call it Lama Ling. Actually, this place name is Rinzin Gatsal. Dunyo Rinpoche give a Rinzin Gatsal, but Lama become there. One after hundreds of Lama stay there, and they married with the Kongbo girls, women, because we call it Kongbo is because of this one of the protector, what called Dorje Yudun is, and Dorje Yudun, her concert is called Dorje Lekpa. Dorje Lekpa is a concert. A male and female is Dorje Yudun. Therefore, in Dorje Yudun is, even Jigme Lingpa used to say, she is beautiful. Therefore, this Kongpo is at there is the guardian is Dorje Yudun. Therefore, Kongpo ladies are very beautiful, wonderful. So they love Ngakpas, Lamas. So most of Lamas, I don't know, maybe some of monk or whatever, they all become wonderful Ngakpas under Dunyo Rinpoche, and they are wonderful practitioners. So this Lama Lingpa, what you call Lama Ling, so Lama Lingpa is now. Even Lama Lingpa is now carrying on after in 1950s, we have the earthquake, and that Sangdopuri was demolished, but after that, after what call is cultural revolution was over, then Semo Deshin, one of the Dunyo Rinpoche's eldest daughter, and Chunyi, Lama Chunyi. So they make it, repair it, copper color palace, and Lama Ling still running. And so this is a sort of things. So then many things could be said, but then after that, Dunyo Rinpoche, time to time, he used to come to Pema Kuya, and but he doesn't stay there because Lama Ling become his prime center. And then also many centers, in because he have a proof of sight by Guru Mbuchi, one wonderful Chöda in Lhasa. So that's all. So lots of things happened, wonderful thing happened. He left Pemukhe, but he became the teacher of the old Tibet. I was thinking, if he were staying in the Pemukhe, small country, we are lucky, but he will not become like this teacher of old Tibet. So it was so wonderful, he went there, and of course we are still longing that he should come back and stay with us. This is our hope, but he have to do a lot of work. So as Guru Mboche told him to do this, so he have done like, yeah, these are sort of my memories. Very simple. He is as anyone can, baby can ask, he can answer him. And he's always very soft. And another memory I have to, I remember now that he come to Orissa to teach. That was around 65, 66 at that time. At that time we asked, we want to go to study something, higher studies. So Dzogchen Rinpoche told us, to me and Lama Dawa, says, you have to go to Varanasi for learning there, and you must keep steady bit of something here with the, around we have one learned Lama, you have to study and you'll be ready to go to Varanasi. At that year, he was giving teaching again in Orissa. So we have some house like this. This is well done. And then we have a tent as a bathroom where he have to use the Latin, he goes. And I was, because I love him very much and I know, but I didn't know such people love that more than me. And when Lama Rinpoche just went to bathroom and he went back, then everyone is crowd in his tent, the bathroom tent. Then I was asking, what's going on here? And we go and ask people. They say, oh, they're taking the shit of Dzogchen Rinpoche. They want to save his shit. They want to just, then they take this shit and then mix with this, some mud, and then make a small tablet and they keep it in the sun. And then when dry, they keep it. And they sometimes they have problem, incurable disease. They eat it and they apply when they have a wound, the cancer type of wound. They apply it, everything, it work. They used to. So then, actually, like Chenzi Chuji Lodri, I think he told many people, he's because he followed Nyingman Satyabod. So Guru Mboche, living, Dzogchen Rinpoche is living Guru Mboche. You should go and take teaching from him. Even many Satyapas follow, like Dongto Tenpe Jansen and others. They are following Dzogchen Rinpoche. Everyone become his son. Everyone become like and another thing I have to say that is, when he was in Lhasa teaching, there was a Gelug Kenpo Achung. He followed Dzogchen Rinpoche, and then after that, we never know that they have a very close student. And then he, after that, he was in jail. Then he written this Namja Buddhist commentary, almost like 200 pages are written by Kenpo Achung. So I have this collected those things, but now it's a manuscript. So I want to do more in making in computer and want to revise, because he written lots of things with the Kamba dialect. So many things to do work. So anyway, so there is Satya, Kaiju, Kilu, Nyingma, Common, everyone become his student and everyone love. And some people also make it jealous because of his so learned and so too much students. Jealous was also happen. Because that, then he have to leave for Bhutan and these things. Yeah.
Okay, Rinpoche, thank you very much.
Same to you.